Teofimo Lopez Sr. and Jr. Lopez Sr. and Jr. I just seen you at the Virgil Ortiz fight right before Bernard Hopkins walked up with his bullshit. Y'all showed up with y'all's talking about $20 million and why we didn't offer you $20 million. Brother, you're not the best at 140 pounds. And for one, why would you not be mad at your promoter, your boss, for not offering you $20 million and putting something on the table for us, whatever that us might have been getting? You should have been mad at him, because I don't know what you're getting paid for Jermaine Ortiz, but you need to concentrate.
On his social media, boxing superstar Teofimo Lopez, two-time lineal champion, 135 undisputed champ. He beat Lomachenko in only 16 fights, made history. Then he became champion at 140, beating Josh Taylor when no one gave him a chance. Everybody picked against him. I happen to say that he wins, and he sure pulled it off. He made it look easy. And now he's fighting Jermaine Ortiz on February 8th. So he reveals that three times he tried to make the fight with Devin Haney happen. He said the first time, the Haneys overpriced themselves. Second time, they didn't show up to the meeting. And the third time, when he called Devin personally, and I knew at the time that he was calling Devin, he says Devin told him, "I don't talk to you. You have a boss. I'll talk to your boss." But he said Spence and Crawford talked to each other and made the fight happen. So Tio did everything he can to make the fight happen. He also has more proof that he tried to make the fight happen with Devin Haney during the fallout with Regis. Enough is enough with all you fakes joining together to make false narratives. Hashtag sheepdog. So he's going to share, I'll share it with you, his messages to the head of the MSG group to bring the fight of him and Devin to the stratosphere, to the dome in Vegas. And he also tried making the fight with Matias, the other 140 champ, the IBF champ, but he had no success with that. And he also tried to make a fight with Kambosos. I believe Tio beat Kambosos the first time. I also believe Kambosos is probably the worst champion in the history of boxing. And besides the win over Teofimo, he really has no mark in his career, anything that anyone would ever remember. Two losses to Haney and probably a loss coming up to Loma. So he says, Joel Fisher, he's the head guy. He says, "I have a business proposal, would like to talk to you. How would you and the chairman of MSG Masquerade Garden like to host Teofimo Lopez, Devin Haney, February 10th, live MSG Sphere on Super Bowl weekend in fabulous Las Vegas?" And Joel Fisher responds, "Sal and I would be more than happy to talk with you about this. We have already started to have conversations with Top Rank, Teo's promoter, with you being the first fight at the Sphere. Haney has been mentioned as a potential opponent for this fight. We also have you headlining the Garden on December 9th, Heisman night. That's the best number to reach you at, and we will call you now. Sounds amazing. Here's my cell." So Teofimo Lopez, he went ahead, and he thinks out of the box. I love what he's doing right now on social media. Every fighter, learn from Tio what he's doing. He's doing a great job. Every day posting different videos. He's not waiting for one highlight video once a month. He's posting different things. He's doing skits. Him going into Burger King, like he's sponsored by Burger King. What does Wilder always tell me? Dream it, live it, achieve it, and bring it into existence. So that's Tio. So he's doing clips of him working out, him with his son, everything. And today he was live for a long time, like 40 minutes. He's doing everything right to get the buzz for the February 8th fight. So those who say that Tio turned down Ryan for low money, he never got the offer. So he doesn't know what that's all about. And you can see he's proactive hitting up the other champions, Devin Haney and Subriel Matias. The last champion is Rowley, which that would be a big fight too, since both of them are very, very big punchers. Tio is looking, of course, to fight Terrence Crawford. He says he's the best. People say Crawford's the best, so he wants to challenge him. But you have to respect Teofimo for what he's doing. He's never turned down a fight, ever. You never hear him say, "I'm not fighting this guy." Tio wants all that smoke. And a guy that Tio beat, Sandor Martin, is just signed with Top Rank, by the way. And he is in line to fight Devin Haney. He was the mandatory for the Haney Regis winner way before that fight happened. The WBC announced it. And Sandor Martin from Spain, he got famous when he fought Mikey and he beat Mikey. And then he fought Tio and it was a good fight. And once Tio hit him, he started running. And very technical, solid guy, not a big puncher. Antio obviously won the fight, but let's see what happens once he steps in the ring, Sandor Martin, to fight Devin Haney. You can't complain about people's resumes in general, I'm saying. So there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.
Ellie Secback reporting. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
I'm Ellie Secback. Ellie Secback reporting. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.